He started to make forward runs, but even Lewandowski's hold-up play was better than I've seen it in recent weeks. A couple of little flicks round the corner, and the two players we talked about before the game, Raphinha had a very good first half, that cross early on in the game where really Lewandowski should have scored with his head, and João Felix, who you've just talked about, was excellent. He tried to run at people, he found that little bit of space in between the midfield and the defenders. And you have to say, Atlético Madrid, in that first half, as we've all been saying, were tepid in terms of their closing down, their understanding of the game. I was screaming at Hermoso throughout the first half. He was trying to get Riquelme to come back and mark the centre forward or come right in against him. And it just allowed 2v1 out in the wide areas. It was horrendous from Hermoso. He was protecting himself and not doing the job for the team.
Robert, been highly critical of Barcelona over recent weeks. Could this prove to be a turning point?
It could be, but those same players that had something to prove today have got to prove it week in, week out. I think the midfield players will be a strong midfield if they can keep those three fit. And they're going to miss Gavi, of course they are, but those three that play today, they're all excellent players. And if you can get games out of João Felix, like he played today, like Raphinha played today, and you can get Lewandowski holding up the play and then getting himself in the box, because he missed chances today, you're going to get good performances from Barcelona. And I thought the manager got it right in playing Araujo at centre-half to mark Morata. He did a good job against him. And Koundé, we saw, get overlapping runs. So this could be the start of Barcelona building their confidence up once again.
I need Sid with a flat cap on. We need the flat cap.
Robbo sleeps in that cap, you know.
He's Peaky Blinders.
Since he's arrived in Spain, he loves it. Overall, is this the recipe now for success for Barcelona going forward? Because we've talked about different lineups and different personnel coming in for Xavi. Is this kind of the start of something?
Well, I think all things being equal, that's probably the best midfield. I don't think there's anybody else. Well,
no, Gavi's out.
Gavi's
yeah.
out, but well, you could still argue. Pedri, Gundogan, who's the other one?
De Jong.
And Frankie De Jong, sorry, who's been out for a while. I think that gives them the balance in there. And as Robbo mentioned during the half, it allowed Gundogan to do a couple of things. It allowed them some freedom to go up and support along with Pedri, but it also allowed him to come back in and sit in there alongside with De Jong at certain times as well. And I think De Jong back is huge for them. Pedri offers different things going forward. I mean, last year we saw him play as a second striker alongside Lewandowski. He gives flexibility to the manager. You know, João Cancelo at left back at the moment seems to be what he's going for over young Baldi. And I think that front three, for sure, at this moment in time as we speak, is their go-to front three with the younger players coming off the bench. So yeah, in terms of his best 11 with Ter Stegen to come back in, he's probably absolutely on that at the moment.
Lewandowski going to be OK, Robbo?
I think he is. I mean, he missed three good chances. The one with his head that he should have just let slide off his forehead. I think he was waiting for Oblak to come out and knock him out almost.
Does today's result change that?
It's a very frustrating performance overall from Atletico Madrid, because if there was ever a time to play against Barcelona, this is it.
Yeah.
It's a team that was vulnerable. It's a team that is lacking confidence and was lacking confidence coming into this match. We have heard Xavi over the last few weeks talking about sensaciones, well, feelings. The feeling about Barcelona and around Barcelona hasn't been all that positive. And the players sense that. The fans sense that. The coaches sense that. Atletico Madrid didn't sense that.
Yeah.
They didn't feel it. They didn't look at this as an opportunity, and they didn't quite approach the game in the manner in which I thought that they should. Go and attack Barcelona. Go and expose those feelings that they're having right now, the discomfort, the lack of confidence. Go and expose it because you can, because you have proven that you can over the course of the season. Instead, they chose to take a step back, in which you're not seeing a sliding challenge in the middle of midfield from Rodrigo de Paul with that sort of energy and that sort of intensity. You're not seeing a team that gets in anybody's face or wins a 50-50 challenge or wins duels. If you're not seeing that from Atletico Madrid, then I don't think you're going to see the quality in the attack either. And therefore, at this point, they come up short. And I don't know how important it is, the fact that they hadn't won in Barcelona since 2006, but that continues. And I don't know how important it is, the fact that Diego Simeone has never won at Barcelona, but that continues. Mm. That continues. This was, I think, a missed opportunity for Atletico Madrid to really make a statement for themselves. You know what? This is a year in which we can win the league title.
When we took a look at those fixtures, as Sid quite rightly mentioned, you looked at Porto, you looked at Atletico Madrid. Two down, one to go for Barca in this run as they take on Girona next Sunday. And that'll be our feature game at 2:30 Eastern.